So, over my break, I have continued building as I always do, and I thought I'd show you one of my builds today, which has been hammered quite a bit, but is worthwhile talking about. So this is the Tiny Trainer by 533. Designed, I think, by Evan Turner, and obviously designed very much around the DRL look. And the idea of this guy was just to give him a little frame that he could practice with in small areas. And I bought mine on a whim. The Malta's, which are 14R4s, 4533 kV. So slightly unusual, pernickety kV. But this was just bought and built on a whim. And the difference between mine and the majority that you will see is mine has a partially decased Cadex Vista in it. So the idea of this guy is just a small scale, tiny DRL-esque quad to fly in small spaces, and it's pretty quiet and light. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take it apart and then I'll show you how I've built it. But just before I do, mine has these wires on top, and you'll notice that my canopy has these little rounded holes on it because mine's been designed to carry a decased Hero 7 or Hero 6. So I just have a little mount which slides through and bolts on to there using the Ter FPV GoPro light mount. And that was just at a whim, and I'll show you some of the footage that you can get doing that. But this guy has some quirks and some really nice designs that are worthwhile looking at, and one of them is this canopy, which a little bit annoying, you zip tie on or you could tape it on. This canopy is made out of sort of almost like a prop material, similar to the arm guards on the Impulse RC Apex. And it is an absolute triumph because in my experience it just doesn't break. And this little guy of mine has been absolutely hammered and it's still going. And you'll see all I've done to fit it with the Vista is basically just trim a little bit of the material off around the Vista there, and then it fits straight on. And the reason I've decased the Vista is because I've seen a few of these done elsewhere, and what the majority of people do is basically just run taller standoffs. But I think it ruins the look because the arm guard plastic bits tend to stick a little bit proud. So I thought I would try decasing the Vista and see what would happen, and my results have been frankly amazing. Nothing bad has happened at all. I've flown this in the hottest days we've had in the UK, when the temperature's been sort of 32 odd degrees, and it's done absolutely fine. So if I just lift this canopy out of the way, they're the wires that I just attached for my Hero. But you'll see what I've got here is I've got the usual 25 by 25 all-in-one flight controller. This one is one of those JH MSU boards. And then all I've done is literally removed all of the heat sinks from the Vista to give it a lower profile, except the top one. And the reason I've left the top one is just to give it some protection because it sticks slightly out the side of the canopy. And if you look at the bits that I've removed, which are these three pieces, the weight I have saved, if I just wait for this guy to reset, the weight I've saved is basically 6.68 grams. which on something this small is the difference between it flying well and not at all. And the rest of the build besides that is really simple. In terms of how I've mounted it, the Vista on its outside has these silly M1.6 screws. All I've done is just used standard M2 screws and screwed up. And because the Vista is made out of this lightweight aluminium, you can just thread straight through. So I've just used M2 screws up, and then I've just used a little plastic spacer or little plastic standoff, and then a little nut holding it in place, and it's been absolutely fantastic. Got a fairly hefty capacitor on the back of it, because these Gemsu boards, like all these all-in-one boards, are a little bit noisy. And at the back of that I have a TBS Crossfire Nano. Now I'm running my antennas in sort of like an L shape, just using very small zip ties. The actual kit comes with sort of a little Crossfire mount and receiver mount for the mini mortal. And this worked great for a week or two, but then randomly I was fail-safing all over the place. And I've taken this out, and this was the culprit. So somewhere in this cable, I'm guessing there's a cut that I can't see, because the rest of it is fine. But by the time you add up the weight of that and this, I've actually saved weight just by using, as I said, these little tiny zip ties and just attaching them to the back of the standoffs, like so. Antenna, I was hoping to use basically a whip antenna, a dipole antenna, but when I tried it with the Vista, it was awful. So I don't know if I had a particularly bad linear antenna, or whether the Vista is just far more susceptible to a decent antenna than the full-size air unit, which works fine with little dipoles. But anyway, I've just put this new Emax sort of micro lollipop or nano lollipop on it, which weighs a couple of grams. It's not the best antenna in the world, but it does absolutely fine for what I want. There isn't really a lot else to say. I'm running the full-size DJI camera because the Nebula is still rubbish. This one has been just strengthened up a little bit, because I found that the mount that 533 had designed for the Vista was a little bit weak in comparison to the one that they've made for a normal analog camera. And it's been working an absolute treat. So the things that I love about it are, A, as I said, this canopy, which just seems to last for whatever reason. But B, instead of being a sort of toothpick which lasts me all of about 5 seconds before I inevitably break an arm or something falls off, this guy is made out of really wide carbon, which I think is 1.5 or 2 mils thick. I'll put it in a subtitle. And it seems to take one hell of a pounding. And the other thing I really like, which I didn't expect to do, is instead of using sort of rubber bands or a lipo strap, you have this 3D printed sort of cocoon which holds your battery, which weighs, you know, a couple of grams and just mounts to the bottom of the frame and the flight controller. And the thing I love is, no matter how many times you crash this guy, you never ever eject your battery. It just stays locked in place, which, when I've flown these guys before, bottom mounted little quads, if you have a crash, 9 times out of 10, your battery goes flying 40 miles away, you can't find it, and it's a pain up the backside. And this simple solution has really sort of made this guy a pleasure to fly. You can see in this case, I'm using these Gemfan 3016 props, which I think are fantastic props. I hate Gemfan props generally, but these are really super smooth. You can see I'm using M2 screws to hold my props in, and that's because these props have had a bit of life in them. What I've been finding is, when you first get the props and they're fresh, you can sort of push them on, because the Tiny Trainer mortars have 2 mil shafts like the FPV cycle ones. You can shove them on and they'll stay in place if you're lucky and you don't hit trees or scraggle, etc. But the minute that they've seen, half a dozen packs and been clumped and clonked into things, they tend to come off when you least expect it. So I've just started using screws on mine, and sadly, it does take a sniff of performance away from the little guy, but I'd rather have that than suddenly lose a prop when I'm doing, a power loop or whatever. So, what do I think of this guy? Now, mine is really ugly. Everybody else will probably build theirs analog. They'll be using smaller components. It'll be lighter than mine. It'll be faster than mine. And it'll probably also have those lovely LEDs, which I'm not using simply because it's too heavy anyway. I absolutely love it. Using the Betaflight PIDs and settings that he's posted, I literally copied and pasted those into Betaflight. I think I've increased D maybe by about 3 points and maybe dropped P by one, but it flies absolutely fantastic. And I know there's a sort of odd wobble, and in some of the footage that you're looking at, I was using these props which are scuffed and bent, but it doesn't really matter. I'm flying a quad that is really, really quiet with HD FPV feed, and it flies, or should I say, feels absolutely fantastic. So all up with all its gubbins on and props on, mine weighs 123 grams. So it's way heavier than a true toothpick would be, but super light compared to the average 3-inch. And here's a 3-inch that I built over the summer, and this one is using T-Motor F1507 motors. Really nice motors, these, super smooth. And it's also got the FETEC flight controller in it. And if you look at the difference, this one, which has been built as light as I can basically make it, I've removed all the TPU, etc., from this little iFlight frame, which I wouldn't recommend, it's really weak. But it comes in at a weight of sort of 175 grams. So sort of 50 grams difference, and the difference in noise is huge. So this guy, quite often you hear people saying it flies like a 5-inch. Nothing flies like a 5-inch except a 5-inch. However, this guy, being slightly underpowered and pretty porky, it has throttle resolution for days, and it's just super fun to fly. It doesn't feel like one of these sort of bricks with jetpacks on, like this guy can do, where you've got tons of speed but very little all-out control when you're in a tight space. This guy just sort of floats and dances, and it hasn't got a ton of punch, and it's not mighty fast, but what it is super, super fun. And this is coming from a guy who, generally speaking, hates little quads. I always build them, and then I go back to my 5-inch quads because they're what make me happy. This guy I've built, tuned, flown, it flies great. It's been flown about twice, and then it's been gathering dust. This guy has been out and about with me everywhere. When I've had a bad day at work, I'll just throw a few of these 553S R lines in and go and rip, a few packs, and it just makes me smile. These are the batteries that you want, by the way, the slim 550s 3S, because they weigh a ton less, or the GMB version, they weigh a ton less than the normal. So these guys weigh 45 grams. A normal 3S 550, and this is basically a reskinned GMB, weigh pretty much 10 grams more, 9 grams more for the same size battery. And are these skinny batteries as good as these ones? Probably not, but that's a hell of a weight saving. So once you get you get the quad and all its gubbins, props, you add the battery, you're looking at an all-up weight of 166 grams, and you have a little tiny quad, which is super quiet. It can do all the tricks and acro stuff that you would ever want to do. And it just puts an absolute smile on my face. I never thought I would say it, which is why I haven't, you know, reviewed it or done anything with it. You know, this has seen dozens and dozens of packs. It's been slammed, it's been crashed. As I said, the Vista has been absolutely fine, even when I keep losing it in the trees after crashing and it's sat, you know, cooking itself for 10 minutes, it's been fine. It's just, for me, the ultimate non-toothpick toothpick, because it's everything I want it to be and it doesn't break. And for me, that is infinitely better than, you know, a toothpick with a Vista. And I've built quite a few, but they last me 2 minutes before I'm inevitably repairing them in one way or the other. So between its really nice, clever canopy and this little 3D printed battery sling, I think it's fantastic. And you can print off wider or bigger sleeves if you want to use a different size battery. So yeah, I'm absolutely in love with it. Obviously mine is pretty ugly. It's been heavily used. It's not pretty and doesn't have all the LEDs on, but I don't really care. The motors are super sweet. They're really coggy, but in the air they feel really smooth and they make a lovely quiet whistling sound. So yeah, 533 Tiny Trainer, probably the most fun thing I've seen in a long time. Because for me, even with the Vista adding, you know, 20 grams maybe compared to an analog build, it just does what I wanted it to do. And if you want to see, these things always look smaller in the flesh than on camera, that's a 5-inch quad, and there's the Vista, there's the 533. So yeah, props to 533 and whoever designed this, whether it was Evan Turner or somebody behind the scenes. But yeah, absolutely love this guy. It is super fun. Flight times are anything from 3 minutes to about 59 seconds. Basically, you can fly this guy at full bore for a whole pack if you've got enough space. And you'll see on the flight footage that there is no finesse in any of my flying, and that's not because this guy can't do it. It's because I'm just throwing it around and having fun and putting a smile on my face. So in terms of a quad, I suppose it's as pure an FPV experience as you could possibly find, because there's no pretense to it. It's just, yeah, just a barrel of laughs. So I am not a racer. I have never raced. I have no love or interest in chasing hoops, but I kind of quite fancy getting this guy out and hopefully finding some of the local lads who have other little 3-inch or toothpicks and just having a barrel of laughs. Yeah, racing and having fun and, yeah, everything that the hobby should be about. So that is it. My favourite little toothpick style 3-inch or 2-inch quad that I've ever reviewed. And this guy is, in comparison, absolutely shit. Because this guy, while it's super fast and flies great, I may as well fly my 5-inch. Cheers, guys. That's all for me. Bye-bye. The moment that I step outside.